morning, treasurers. This is your host, Partha Shah, co-founder of Knight Fintech, and you are listening to Knight Snippets. Here is all what you need to know before going into trade for 5th July 2021 in the international market. Non-farm payrolls for June 2021 came at 8.5 lakhs versus an estimate of 7 lakhs. But the unemployment rate came at 5.9% versus an expectation of 5.6% and 5.8% in the prior month. Hence, even though at 8.5 lakhs, NFP was great, US economy is far away from Fed's full employment mandate, where unemployment rate is sticky at 5.9%. With this new information pricing in on Friday itself, US 10-year closed 4 basis points down at 144 percentage points and 30-year 2 basis points down at 205 on Friday. US markets will be closed on account of US Independence Day today. In the crude oil market, crude is trading at $75.87 per barrel. Short-term range for crude is $74 to $77, and the near-term target for crude is $80 per barrel. In the currency market, dollar index is at 92.30. Today's range for dollar seems to be 92.18 to 92.55. The DXY will be range-bound. The NFPs were great, but the sticky unemployment rate is not comforting for the dollar, and dollar guys, dollar bulls will have to find new information to take DXY at 93. USD CNY or Chinese Yuan is at 647. USD INR with a high of 74.87 closed at 74.74. USD INR's range for today seems to be 74.25 to 74.55. Now, if we talk about the trading strategy for USD INR, remember Friday itself we had asked you to book all the profits at 74.65 to 74.70 levels before the NFP release late in the evening. It seems it has worked out well. USD INR saw an intraday high of 74.87 and closed at 74.74. So average exit would be above 74.80. Now, the USD INR counter will be range bound with a bias towards 74.50 and lower. In the domestic market, let's analyze the Indian bond market starting with Friday's G-Sec auctions. 563-2026 cutoff came at 572, but out of rupees 11,000 crore auction size, rupees 10,495 crore, I repeat, rupees 10,495 crores were devolved on PDs. A big setback for RBI, as even at 572, investors are not ready to buy 5-year paper. GOI FRB 2033 at 492, 664 2035 at 674, with rupees 12,500 crore successful acceptance, including green shoe option of rupees 2,500 crore. 667 2050 at 713. Because of the huge devolvement on PDs, 563 GS 2026 saw a sharp sell-off on Friday after the cutoff results. 563 GS 2026 closed at 575 versus 571 the previous trading day. Massive 4 basis points down. 664 2035 closed at 673 versus 671 the previous trading day. Now, the trading strategy for G-Secs would be, we had applied for 664 GS 2035 at 9909 to 9912 range in the auctions, for which we have received the allocations for majority of our clients. We will try to hold the position for now, waiting for GSEP announcements, as 664 and 563 will be the main beneficiaries in this quarter. Knight Research team is keeping an eye on 563-2026 for a value buy. Trading range for 585-2030 would be 603 to 608 with a bias towards 605. An important news, as the government's market borrowing program has faced several hurdles this year with weak demand, the RBI has tweaked government bonds auction methodology. Henceforth, the RBI will auction benchmark gilts of 2-year, 3-year, 5-year, 10-year and 14-year tenure and floating rate bonds using uniform price auction method. Hence, all the bidders will get the same single uniform price, and bidding is completely avoided at bidders were bidding at a very high yields where RBI was not comfortable. It is now to be seen on how investors are bidding at all at GSEC auctions with uniform pricing. Only time will tell. That's it for today. You were listening to Night Snippets with Parthesh Shah, co-founder of Night FinTech. See you tomorrow with the new episode of Night Snippets.